$850, a small but significant amount of money, because when an unelected San Diego agency head donates $850 to a candidate who's running against one of that agency head's bosses, that raises eyebrows, and you're going to hear a lot more about this story. Here's Voice of San Diego's Jesse Marks to explain. All right, so Jesse, before we get into this story, I have to start the way we always start with this subject. Just refresh us, what exactly is SANDAG?
SANDAG is the association, it's the San Diego Association of Governments, and what it does locally, the purpose that it serves is it's the main agency in charge of transportation planning and just regional planning in general. So it tends to oversee not only the long-term trajectory of what transit, freeways, all those sorts of things look like, but also housing as well. So it serves a kind of research role and a planning, public planning role as well.
And because of that, it's very powerful in kind of structuring the future of San Diego County.
Yeah, it's particularly powerful because it lays the vision for what the future of the county is going to look like. It decides essentially where people are going to live and how they're going to live and how they're going to move about the region. But it's also powerful because it includes representatives from across the region. So it's the place where mayors, even city council members, board of supervisors, they all get together and then make these strategic long-term decisions together for the entire region. And so they think of it in terms of the region rather than their own little entity.
And so now we have this fairly new executive director of SANDAG, Hassan Ikrada. And talk to me about him for a second, because my understanding is he's perhaps thought of as a progressive thinker when it comes to public transportation. And he is, you know, in a short number of years, really tried to push big plans to revitalize and renew public transit in San Diego. Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. So Hassan came from the Southern California Association of Governments, and he also had a regional view, but a broader view of these sorts of things. He came into SANDAG in late 2018 after the previous executive director had resigned in scandal. And Hassan came in as this sort of more idealistic person who was going to tell it to you straight. And at the same time, he was genuinely concerned about the region meeting its climate change goals, as well as building out more transit. So Hassan was very clear from day one that if the region were serious about meeting its mandates to reduce its greenhouse gas emissions and needed to completely rethink the way that it was structured and the way that it was moving San Diegans around. But the problem was that the agency had been previously tied to a sales tax increase from 2004, which had made certain promises to the public. And so voters who approved that sales tax and approved that money coming into the agency are expecting it to go towards freeways and towards roads. So what's been established over the last couple of months is this, maybe not necessarily a fair one, but it's been a roads versus transit type argument at SANDAG among its leaders now that Hassan is a part of it.
Okay, so that brings us to this month. This is something that I actually think the Republican Party of San Diego maybe brought up first. You've done a ton of reporting since then. It was a big development this month that Hassan Ikrada was donating to local politicians. Who was he donating to?
So the first donation we noticed was to Tara Lawson Reamer. She's an economist, a professor who's running for the District 3 supervisor's race. And that is significant to us because she's running against Kristen Gaspar, who currently represents District 3, which is Escondido, Encinitas. It's parts of northern San Diego, the city. So it's got a more like rural suburban type feel to it. And Gaspar's been one of the leading voices of opposition to Ikrada's plan long term, and has rejected this notion. She says that she's not necessarily opposed to transit, but she has rejected the notion that the region needs to fundamentally rethink the way that it moves people around. So she's argued, you've made a promise to voters to expand roads and freeways, you should continue doing that. So she has served with others as a voice of opposition to Hassan. So Hassan donates to Tara Lawson Reamer, who's Kristen Gaspar's opponent. And the significance of that, of course, is unelected leaders of public agencies don't typically weigh into those races.
Yeah, please. I mean, what is the significance of that? I mean, it seems as though this is, as you said, an unelected officer trying to side with politicians who would be more favorable towards his direction.
It's not typical for this to happen. I've been covering politics for almost a decade, and I actually can't think of a similar instance of this, but Hassan is known as this guy who kind of just says what he thinks and he stands behind it and he's ideological he's principled in that sense. And so Hassan is clearly donating to a campaign that he personally prefers. But the issue with it is that he's also taking a side on who he would rather have as his boss going forward, because the way it works is at the county is the county board of supervisors is made up of five people. Kristen Gaspar is just one of them, but she's been appointed to Sandag along with one of her colleagues. So the supervisor's race is directly tied to Sandag in that sense. And there are typically, I mean, not typically, but there are openly, there are rules against this sort of thing. What Hassan did was not illegal by any sense, but it's widely considered among public officials to be unethical to take such an open side with your pocketbook in favor of a candidate.
Jesse, you know, and I think that it just underscores how probably the most watched race in the county when it comes to November will continue to be that District 3 supervisor race, because it really controls or determines so much of where the county will go forward.
Yeah, and so what happens is if Kristen Gaspar wins, the Republicans will maintain control of the Board of Supervisors, and then they'll maintain control over the appointments to Sandag. But if Tara Lawson Reamer wins, it switches. Democrats will have a partisan majority on the board, and then they will appoint their own people to it. It's a very, very significant race, and it's largely flown under the radar, which is kind of surprising, because I mean, we're talking about the long-term trajectory of the region and the way that people move around. So it's a pretty big deal.
Jesse Marks, Voice of San Diego, thank you so much for your time. Great story, and we'll talk to you soon.
Thanks, Danny.
We'll be right back.